All right, I am here with Jennifer Rashwan and Kate Parkes. Can you tell the world your real job titles?
I'm manager of publicity and promotions at Alliance Films.
And I'm coordinator of publicity and promotions at Alliance Films.
So just for people who maybe aren't as familiar with some of the terminology, can you explain like what a roundtable is, what a press conference is, what are the differences?
A roundtable is just an interview with one talent and then multiple press.
And then press conference is sort of the same idea, except that with roundtables we can more control who's going to be in the roundtable, whereas press conferences at TIFF go to any accredited press. So you could be at a press conference with a lot of international press, a lot of American press, and with journalists who will ask questions like, "What's if you had a superpower, what superpower would it be?" You know what I mean? We have more control over that in our roundtables. It's kind of a free-for-all at a press conference.
Do you feel like the advent of more technology and more online media is really changing? Is that part of why that's changing? Because I saw like a major news outlet interviewing a major celebrity using an iPhone.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like, this was a news outlet. It wasn't like just some journalist from, you know, Etobicoke, you know?
Yeah, no, for sure.
I've never had to do so many roundtables because online media, that's pretty much what online media does now is roundtables, and I've never really had to account for that time as much before now. Now it's like almost half of my schedule is online press.
Do movies and stars get more mileage out of a print article or a TV feature or like a good blog article? What's the most successful publicity method?
I think it depends. It depends on the film, whereas like an older film with an older audience would be more print, where if it's something that's newer, we usually try to do a lot of online because that's where the audience is.
We still want to get the paper and see that person on the front page. That's still such a big deal. I don't know that it should be, but it's still, it's hard to like transition out of that mindset and be like, oh, well, we got front story on MSN's homepage. You know what I mean? Like, it's hard.
Yeah.
And still haven't switched over to that. Like, that's an awesome thing too. But it's just different than being able to
hold it
in your
hand
and going around the office and like, look at this.
There's a star in town who has maybe a tumultuous personal life, and questions are going to naturally sort of veer in that direction. What do you do?
We're actually really fortunate, and our Canadian press are very respectful. If the circumstance came up where a question was inappropriate, we would say, no, we're here to talk about the film, or you know, don't have to answer that,
right,
or we'll end it early.
Very rarely. I have cut off interviews before, but it's happened maybe twice in my whole like 6 years of doing this.
I would love to know, you have, I'm sure, a ton of different emergencies and last minute things coming up. How do you sort of deal with those? Like, what are your strategies?
Jen and I actually have a funny story of a press day that we were on in TIFF.
So we were running about, I would say, 30 to 40 minutes late on this particular press day, and one of our talent had to go to his American press day in the hotel, and he couldn't run late, and he had to go there right after ours. So we almost lost him for about half of the roundtables he was supposed to do, which would have been like 8 to 9 journalists. And to tell a journalist you're not going to get the biggest star of the film, it's a bad conversation to have. So we're just, the day is going, and we just keep looking at each other like, we're in trouble. How are we going to catch up here? And there was just really, kept looking at the schedule, and we're like, oh, what are we going to do? There's no way. And then finally it just hit me. I'm like, okay, we're going to have a mini press conference. We just merged our two roundtables.
So I looked at Jen and was like, how are we going to be fair about this? Because we don't know if all of our press will be able to get questions. So how do we choose who gets a question? So we did it just like you do in grade 5 and put all the names in a hat and literally just pulled them out. Thankfully, it went really well and all of the press got a question and we high-fived and hugged afterwards.
I was so worried, but they all came out with like the biggest smile on their faces, like, that was great. Like, they all loved it and it worked out really well and we were right on time. The personal publicists were happy with us, we were happy. Yeah. And
talent was happy, I think, as well, because sometimes it's easier when they're paired with more than one person.
Yeah.
Just to kind of take off the load off the question and they can kind of play off each other, so it's not much like we're doing now.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
You two are awesome.
You're awesome. Thank you for this.
That was really fun.
Awesome.
It was great.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.